Today, I'm addressing one of the most frequently asked questions I receive. How can you create a consistent environment for your AI-generated stories? Sometimes the setting can play a starring role. Think of House Moving Castle or The Flying House in Up. These are not just backdrops. They're dynamic, enchanting structures that become integral to the story. It's not uncommon for non-human objects to hold special significance in the story. And today, I'm sharing my AI image workflow for creating consistent characters and environments that will elevate your storytelling.
It may be a bit unconventional, but it's a method you may not have seen before. And the best part is that I'll show you how to do it all using free tools. Let's get started. First, we need to have a story in mind with our characters and environment defined. It's important to understand who your characters are and the world they live in. For today's demonstration, I have prepared the characters of Red Riding Hood, a wolf, and a charming little house. For the best results, it's best to remove the background from each image so we can isolate the subjects to prepare for the next step. Next, we want to create a full 3D view of the house and the characters so we can easily place them in different orientations for image generation. For this, we'll be using Triple AI, a free 3D model generation tool that creates high quality 3D models from just a reference image. I'll include all the links mentioned below. Let's sign in to get started. If you just sign up, you'll receive 600 free credits per month as a free user, which should be plenty to try it out. We can see a lot of high quality 3D models as examples. If you click on one, you can use your mouse to rotate it and preview the 3D model. The level of detail and quality is really impressive. This robot is so cute. Now let's create one using our own example. You can type your text here to prompt the AI to create a 3D model, but for today's workflow, we'll use an image to generate the 3D model. Let's upload this house and create it using 25 credits. After a short while, it's done. If you're not happy with the result, you can regenerate it again for free. This one is the best one I've generated. The added details are impressive. It imagined the back of the house and even adding details to the bottom. Let's go ahead and generate 3D models for the other characters as well. Next, we want to place the 3D models we've generated in the correct orientation and combine them to create an image. Then we'll use the image-to-image technology to generate a new image based on that. To make sure that it doesn't get too complicated and cater to different needs, I'm sharing two ways we can do this. The easy way is to go back to the 3D models on Triple AI and adjust your 3D object to the desired angle and position. Simply take a screenshot of it in that orientation, and then we'll use a tool like Design AI to assemble them together. All the features we'll be using today are available in their free plan. Let's go to Design AI, log in, and open a new project. In Design, we'll use the design display on the canvas as a reference and use the image-to-image tool to generate a new image from the items on the canvas. So first, upload the screenshots and then remove their backgrounds with just one click. We also want to add a background image because the image-to-image tool considers the look of your reference image when creating the new image. We don't want the background to be the default transparent black color. I like to use the text-to-image tool to generate the background. Then we can select a style. For this purpose, since we just want a simple reference for color, I think the simplified scenic style is the best choice. In the result panel, we'll see four different results. Let's double click on the one we like and send it to the canvas. Then we can place things in the right positions. Now we can use the image to image tool on the left to generate the new image. Click the style option. There are many styles to choose from, but for my story, I want to use Vibrant Whimsy, which I think is super cute for a children's book style. For the text prompt, you can type in your own, but I prefer to click auto prompt here so the AI can describe what it sees on the canvas. And then I adjust the text prompt after to fit my need. I also prefer to make the text prompt as simple as possible and keep only the important elements because adding too much can sometimes distract the AI and make the image reference feature less effective. Striking the right balance needs some experimentation. So try it yourself. The style intensity adjusts how strongly the chosen style is presented in the result. The structure match adjusts how well the generated image matches the content structure. For my purpose, I like to start with a higher scale for more consistency with the reference image. But we can always adjust later according to the situation. We want to turn on color match so that AI can better preserve color tones in the reference image. It also increases the strength of structure match. Since we have a human character in the image, we want to turn on face match so it can preserve the facial features of our character. In the advanced settings, we can enter things we don't want to see in the image, like low quality, pixelated, distorted. And if we don't want to see certain objects, we can also input things like cars. Let's hit generate and see what we get. The generated results overall match the approximate colors on my canvas, but I feel like the colors on the roof are not as colorful as I want them to be. So for this, I'll add more descriptive colors for the roof in the text prompt and generate again. Now the results are better aligned in colors, especially the roof. Sometimes in cases like this, we can describe more of what we want in the text prompt to reinforce it, bring the result closer to our vision. And oftentimes the results are not perfect, and we may need to manually adjust the image to achieve more consistency. Luckily, we can easily do that in design. For example, let's say I want to change the colors of these two protruding structures on the side. We can use the selection tool to select the parts where we want to change the colors and click on the color option and pick the color we want to change to. Click done. And we'll change the color of the selected area without losing other details like patterns or texture. Additionally, we can regenerate a part with the color we have in mind. Suppose I want to add a stone step underneath the door in the same color as the wall. We can use the brush tool, pick the color we want, and adjust the stroke size. Then we paint over the area where we want to generate the stone step. Next, we go to the AI editor in the toolbar, select local edit, and type in the text prompt. I'll type stone step. We'll choose the same style we used before. Set the style intensity. For the control method, we select which source of guidance is more important for the mark area. You can pick from prompt, balance, or image. We'll set the control method to image so that the AI will reference more from the existing image to generate the result. Then click generate. This way we can generate a partial region on the canvas with the color we want using local edit. For those who want even more control, we can put all of our 3D models in the same environment for a different kind of experience. This way, you can place them together and adjust directly in a 3D environment to better visualize certain scenes. For this, the easiest platform I find is Spline, which is a free 3D design software that allows users to create 3D objects and design directly in a web browser. And don't worry, the process we're going to do isn't super technical. It's an intuitive platform and we're only going to use it to position our 3D models and nothing else today. I'll keep this as simple as possible. First, use the link below or go to spline.design and log in. You'll see a bunch of tutorials teaching you how to create 3D models in Spline if you're interested in that. They also have plenty of 3D model examples in their library. Click on any of the examples and you can view them in the 3D environment from different angles, even move things around. Let's go back to the dashboard and add a new file. To view from different angles, hold Option and click and drag with your mouse or trackpad. There are two view options. Perspective view is great for creating realistic scenes and final renders. And orthographic view is for precise modeling, aligning objects, and technical work. So for our purpose, perspective view is the one we should use when viewing the scene. When you first open the file, there will be a plain rectangle as a reference. We can delete that and import our own. Let's go back to Triple and download the GLB file of our 3D model. Then just drag the 3D model file into Spline. It will be placed at the starting point 000. To move it, place your cursor on the red, blue, or green arrows, which move it along the X, Y, or Z direction in 3D space. You can also rotate the object using the curved arrows that rotate around different axes. I think using the color axis is the easiest way to move things around and get them to the right position. You can also just drag and drop the object, but just remember to avoid clicking on the axis if you want to do that. Let's add the house as well and put them in the right positions. You may find the objects a bit dark. That's because we haven't added a light source, which could be a complicated process. But for our purpose, we just need to lighten the whole scene up, which is easier. On the right panel, click on light. If we turn up the intensity under the light, we'll brighten the entire scene. We need it to be at an acceptable brightness, so when we transfer the image to generate images as reference, it has the right luminosity to create saturated results. Otherwise, it may affect the generated image and produce muted colors. So adjust this to your preference. This method might make more sense if you're working with a more complex scene, but I'm keeping this simple so it's easier to follow the process. Once we find the right angle, let's take a screenshot, or you can click export to export an image. Back in DeSign, we can upload the image to a new project. Remove the background and use the same method with the image-to-image tool to generate new images. And this is how we generate consistent objects or environments at different angles. These are just for demonstration purposes. It can get more complex with intricate scenes. Different themes and style are also possible with this workflow. Let me know what you think of this process in the comment below. Is it too complicated, or do you want to wait for a proper tool to do this? I hope you find this video helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.